In the previous video, we study how we can solve the texture problem of exercise 3.3 by using substitution method. In this video, we will learn about how we can solve the texture problem of exercise 3.4 by using elimination method. Now the problem is that if we add 1 to the numerator and subtract 1 from the denominator, a fraction reduced to 1. It becomes 1 upon 2. If we add 1 to the denominator, what is the fraction? So, let me start the solution of the problem. Let numerator of a fraction be x and denominator be y. If numerator is x and denominator is y, therefore, fraction equals to numerator upon denominator. Numerator is x, denominator is y. Therefore, fraction equals to x upon y. Now, according to condition is that if 1 is added to numerator and 1 is subtracted from the denominator, fraction reduced to 1. It means if we add 1 to the numerator and subtract 1 from the denominator, the fraction is equals to 1. So, numerator plus 1 upon denominator minus 1 equals to 1. Now, numerator is x. So, x plus 1 upon denominator is y. So, y minus 1 equals to 1. Now, solve x plus 1 equals to y minus 1. Therefore, x minus y equals to minus 2. That is equation number 1. Now, we again move to the second condition of the question. And the condition is that if 1 is added to denominator, fraction becomes 1 upon 2. It means there is no change in the numerator. Only we add 1 to the denominator. So, numerator upon denominator plus 1 equals to 1 upon 2 because there is no change in the numerator, but denominator is increased by 1. So, numerator is x and denominator is y. Therefore, x upon y plus 1 equals to 1 upon 2. Now, solve 2x equals to y plus 1. 2x minus y equals to 1. That is equation number 2. Now subtract equation 1 from equation 2. See the sign of the in both the equation the coefficient of y is same and their sign is also same. So if the sign is same, so we subtract equation 1 from equation 2. Now equation 2 is that 2x minus y equals to 1. Equation 1 is that x minus y equals to minus 2. If we subtract, the signs are reversed. So, minus y and plus y is cancel out. 2x plus 2x and minus 2x, that is equals to x. So, x equals to 3. Now, put the value of x in equation 1. Equation 1 is that x minus y equals to minus 2. Put the value of x. 3 minus y equals to minus 2. Minus y equals to minus 2 minus 3. Minus y equals to minus 5. Therefore, y equals to 5. Therefore, fraction equals to x upon y equals to 3 upon 5. Now the problem is that 5 years ago, Nuri was thrice as old as Sonu. 10 years later, Nuri will be twice as old as Sonu. How old are Nuri and Sonu? So we let's start the solution of the problem. Let the present age of Nuri equals to x years. And present age of Sonu equals to y years. Now, according to question, 5 years ago, it means before 5 years, Noori's present age is X. So before 5 years, Noori's age equals to X minus 5 years. Present age of Sonu is Y. So 5 years ago, it means before 5 years, Sonu's age equals to Y minus 5. Now the condition is that Noori was 3 times as old as Sonu. Therefore, Noori's age equals to 3 into Sonu's age. Now Noori's age is X minus 5 equals to 3 into Sonu's age equals to Y minus 5. So X minus 5 equals to, if you multiply 3 to Y minus 5, 3 by minus 15. Now solve. X equals to 3 by minus 15 plus 5. So X equals to 3 by minus 10. Therefore X minus 3 by equals to minus 10. That is equation number 1. Now 10 years later, it means after 10 years, Noori's age equals to X plus 10 because present age of Noori is X. So after 10 years, Noori's age equals to X plus 10. Sonu's age equals to Y plus 10 years because present age of Sonu is Y. So after 10 years, Sonu's age is Y plus 10. Now condition is that Noori will be twice old as Sonu. It means Noori's age equals to 2 into Sonu's age. After 10 years, Noori's age equals to X plus 10 equals to 2. After 10 years, Sonu's age equals to Y plus 10. Now solve. X plus 10 equals to 2Y plus 20. X minus 2Y equals to 20 minus 10. So X minus 2Y equals to 10. That is equation number 2. Now we subtract the equation 1 from equation 2. Equation 2 is that X minus 2Y equals to 10. Equation 1 is that X minus 3Y equals to minus 10. If we subtract, the sign are changed. So now we subtract. Minus X and plus X is cancel out. So plus 3y minus 2y, that is y. Plus 10 and plus 10, 20. So y equals to 20. Now put the value of y in equation number 2. Now equation 2 becomes X minus 2y equals to 10. Put the value of y. X minus 2y equals to 10. Put the value of y. So X minus 2 into 20 equals to 10. X minus 40 equals to 10. Therefore, X equals to 40 plus 10. X equals to 50 years. Therefore, Noori's age equals to X equals to 50 years. So Sonu's age equals to Y. Now we start the another problem. The sum of the digit of a 2-digit number is 9. Also, 9 times this number is twice the number obtained by reversing the order of the digits. Find the number. So let we start the solution. It is 2-digit number. So we let digit at 10's place be X and 1's place be Y. Therefore, number equals to 10 into 10's digit plus 1's digit. Number equals to 10 into 10's digit is X plus Y. So, number equals to X, 10X plus Y. Now, according to question, sum of the digit of 2-digit number is 9. Sum of the digit of 2-digit number is 9. It means 10's digit plus 1's digit equals to 9. 10's digit is X plus once digit is y equals to 9. That is equation number 1. Now we move to the second condition, and second condition is that if we reverse the order of the digit, it means if we reverse the order of the digit, the tens place becomes x becomes ones digit and y becomes tens digit. Therefore, number formed by reversing the digit equals to 10 into 10 digit plus ones digit. So, number formed by reversing the digit equals to 10y plus x, because if we reverse the order, now y becomes 10's digit and x becomes 1's digit. Now again, we move to the condition. What is it is? 9 times this number is twice the number obtained by reversing the order of the digits. 9 into number equals to 2 into number formed by reversing the digit. That is 9 into number is 10x plus y equals to 2. Number formed by reversing the digit is 10y plus x. So we solve 90x plus 9y equals to 20y plus 2x. Solving. 90x minus 2x plus 9y minus 20y equals to 0. That is 88x minus 11y equals to 0. We take 11 as common. 8x minus y equals to 0. That is 8x minus y equals to 0. That is equation number 2. Now adding equation 1 and 2. Equation 1 is that x plus y equals to 9, and equation 2 is that 8x minus y equals to 0. Why we add equation 1 and 2? We add equation 1 and 2 because in both the equation the coefficient of y is same and their sign is opposite. So no need to change the sign. If there is a need of change the sign, then we subtract, otherwise we add. So plus y and minus y cancel out. So 9x equals to 9. X equals to 9 upon 9, that is X equals to 1. Now we put the value of X in equation 1. Equation 1 is that X plus Y equals to 9. Now put the value of X. The value of X is 1, so 1 plus Y equals to 9. Y equals to 9 minus 1. Y equals to 8. Therefore, number equals to 10x plus y equals to 10 into 1 plus 8 equals to 10 plus 8 equals to. Now problem is that Meena went to a bank to withdraw rupees 2000. She asked the cashier to give her rupees 50 and rupees 100 notes only. Meena got 25 notes in all. Find how many notes of rupees 50 and rupees 100 she received. So let's understand the question. Meena withdraw 200 rupees. It means, and he withdraw only 50 rupees 50 and rupees 100 notes. So value of rupees 50 and rupees 100 notes equals to 2000. And sum of rupees 50 and rupees 100 notes equals to 25. So let's start the solution of the problem. Let number of rupees 100 notes be x and number of rupees 50 notes be y. Value of 1 rupees 100 note equals to rupees 100, because the value of 100 rupees note is 100. So how many 100 rupees note are? There are x 100 rupees notes. So value of x 100 rupees notes equals to 100x. Similarly, value of 1 rupees 50 note equals to 50. So how many notes of rupees 50 are there? There are by rupees 50 notes. So value of y rupees 50 notes equals to 50y. Now, according to question, question is that Meena withdraw rupees 2000 and she withdraw only rupees 50 and rupees 100 notes. So, value of total value of rupees 100 and rupees 50 note equals to 2000 because she withdraw only rupees 100 and rupees 50 notes. It means value of x rupees 100 notes plus value of buy rupees 50 notes equals to 2000 because we let that she withdraw x notes of rupees 100 and buy notes of rupees 50. Value of x 100 note is 100x. Value of y 50 notes, rupees notes equals to 50y. So 100x plus 50y equals to 2000. Now take 50 as common. So 2x plus y equals to 2000. Therefore 2x plus y equals to 40. That is equation number 1. Now again we move to the second condition. Then what is the second condition? Sum of rupees 100 and rupees 50 notes equals to 25 because C buys total 25 notes from the bank. Rupees 100 note is x plus rupees 100 notes be y. So x plus y equals to 25. That is equation number 2. Now subtract equation 1 from equation 2. Equation 1 is that x plus y equals to 25. Equation 2 is that 2x plus y equals to 40. Be subtract because in both the equations the coefficient of y is same but y having a same sign positive. So if they have a same sign we subtract so that we can change the sign. Now change the sign. Minus y and plus y cancel out. Minus 2x and plus x, that is minus x. Minus 40 and plus 25 equals to minus 25. So minus x equals to minus 15. Therefore x equals to 15. Now put the value of x in equation 1. Equation 1 is that x plus y equals to 25. Put the value of y, x equals to 15. So 15 plus y equals to 25. Y equals to 25 minus 15. That is y equals to 10. Therefore number of rupees 100 notes equals to x equals to 15. And number of rupees 50 notes equals to y.